So you want to reset some chunks in your Minecraft world. Maybe a new update's coming out and you want to have those new biomes closer to your house. Maybe your world's really old and it's getting really laggy. Maybe your world's too big and the file size is just huge on your computer space. Regardless of your reason, resetting your chunks in your Minecraft world can be very helpful. Well, lucky for you, there's an amazing free tool where you can reset any chunk in your Minecraft world. So here's how the video is gonna go. First, I'm gonna show you how to install this tool. Then I'm gonna show you the controls, how to work with it, how to do things, and then finally, together, on camera, you're gonna see me fix one of the chunks that I don't like in my Minecraft world. But enough blabbing, let's get to work. So first things first, go to the link down below and click on the GitHub link. GitHub, I don't know. Click on the link down below to take you to this website. So this page is like a helpful guide for how to use this tool for the first time, but that's why you're watching this video. So forget the whole guide, go all the way down and go find the download section. Okay, here's download and installation. So click the version here. My version is 1.13.2. No, that's not the Minecraft version. That's just the installation version. So don't worry about the number, but click this blue button here. Now, lucky for me, I already have this. So now go open up this Java file and let's get to it. So here's how the program looks when you open it. It's just this blank black grid. Now what we're gonna do is import our Minecraft world into here, but big disclaimer, okay? Make a backup, I'll say it again, make a backup. This tool deletes files from your world in real time, so you cannot take that risk. Make a few backups even, test this out, do not mess up. And if you refuse to make a backup, do not comment saying, "Farsi, my world is deleted, my world is corrupted." Why do you sound like the gingerbread man? Point is, don't blame me. Okay, back to the video. So what you're gonna do is click on File, Open, and it's going to open up your Minecraft worlds. So here are mine. I have a test copy world that I'm gonna do. Once again, that's my backup. You're gonna click into that, and you are going to select what you wanna change. If the chunks you want to change are located in the overworld, in the normal Minecraft world, then click region. If you want to do the nether, it is dim-1. If you want to do the end, it is dim-1. So if you want to go regenerate some new nether biomes, it's dim-1. If you want to go get some more like end structures or some more elytra, dim-1. And just for normal old new biomes, region. So I'm going to do region. So you're going to click on the region file and then click select folder. And boom, in a second, your world should pop up here, and there we go. So to control this map, you use the mouse wheel to move around. You use the left click to select things, the right click to unselect things. Now I'm gonna use the mouse wheel to scroll in, and you can see, if you watch me a lot, this is my survival world. Now, even if you don't care about resetting your chunks, this is a great live map of your world, so definitely take advantage of this to get some cool cinematic shots of your world from the sky. So one thing to note is if you are more zoomed in, you can click on like more small selections, but if you are more zoomed out, you can select entire regions like this. Now, if you want to delete something, you are going to just select those areas you want to get rid of, then you're going to go to selection and you can click delete selected chunks. I'm not gonna do that yet, but that's how you do it. Now on the flip side, if you want to delete everything else around a certain area, you could just like select a couple of regions, go back to selection, and you can click invert, which selects everything else besides the sections. So for example, let's say I want to delete this giant treehouse here. I'm gonna select all the squares the treehouse touches, or at least as close as I can to that. Then afterwards, I'm going to go to selection and delete selected chunk. And it says you're gonna delete that many chunks from the world. Okay, whatever, got it. And boom, that is black, which means when I restart the world, that is going to regenerate. Same thing on a bigger scale, if I go select like this entire area over here and I click delete selected chunks, that's a lot of chunks, but I do it, boom, that is black, that's gray. I don't know why some are black, some are gray, but the point is they're all gonna regenerate when you go back in your world. Now, speaking of ungenerated chunks, if you zoom out really far, you can actually see what parts of your world have not even been explored once. So you can actually kind of like track your path of like where you've explored. Very, very interesting, but the load time is kind of long. Okay, let's get a little bit more advanced now. So let's say you don't want to just select like these chunks manually, but you want to kind of like find specific things to regen. So you can go over here to tools and you can do filter chunks. Now basically this filter chunks thing is just a way to specifically find things in your world that you want to reset. So delete all these presets here and let's just start out with one basic new thing. So click the plus, get a new filter. Now there's many things you can do. You can do versions, groups, positions, whatever. But what's a cool one is palette. With palette, you can actually select a certain kind of block that you want to scope out. So if I want to scope out like all the spruce wood in the world, I can type in spruce wood here, then I can find all of that. I also can do biome, which is a little bit more specific for that matter. Also, my favorite is inhabited time. This is great if you want to find a place that you've like been to or you have like some small builds there. So you can type in inhabited time and you can do like greater than or equal to, let's just say like 2 hours. Click OK and boom, this is going to filter any chunk that I've been in for 2 hours or more. And you're seeing it's already starting. It's specifically selecting the chunks that I've been in a lot. So now if I zoom back out, there's only a few places actually, but now I could go to selection, invert, and I can delete everything else that I have not been in for more than 2 hours. Now, once you get the hang of this thing, it's super simple, super easy. But once again, to beat the dead horse again, you have to make backups because if you delete a file, it's gone forever. Now, I think you guys understand how to do this now. Now, here's the fun part. Let's do this together on camera. So let's go to a new world in Minecraft. Okay, so we're gonna make a new single player world and I'm just gonna make it like, I don't know, just test world. Okay, so here we are in a brand new world. So for example, let's find a place that we don't like at all. In fact, here's a better idea. Let's get some lava and let's just grief a giant area. So this whole field here is gonna be covered in lava. Now I'm also gonna put down some purple concrete here. This way you can reference this when we go back into the world. I'll make a little arrow shape here so I can like point to the lava, if that makes sense. Okay, boom, my terrible arrow pointing towards the lava, some purple random stuff, and boom, now we have our world, we have our chunks that we hate, let's go fix them. So we are in MCA selector and click on file, open, and let's go to our test world for video. That was the name of the world. Go inside there. Oh, whoops, I clicked the wrong button. You need to go into the file. Okay, go into the file, then click on the region file because that is the overworld. Select folder. And boom, it's loading up. And there it is, you can already see, there is my giant lava pile right there. And there's my little purple arrow. So as we learned, we're gonna select the places that we don't like. There we go, that's all the lava, the purple's still safe. Now go to selection, wait, no, go to tool, no, it is selection, I'm sorry. Selection, I'm a terrible host here. And click delete selected chunks, and boom, 16 chunks, who cares? Whoa, that's a lot. And you know what, just for the sake of it, let's also get rid of this village because I hate villages. Delete selected chunks and boom, village is gone as well. So there we go, two big landmarks gone. Now let's close this thing out, go back into Minecraft and check it out. All right, single player, test world for video and let's see. The purple's here, the lava is all gone. Now I also realized the village will still be there because there's no new terrain changes, no new updates or anything since I made this little MCA tool change. I'm sure you guys already understand this, but just in case you don't, things only change naturally generating if there's a new update or like something new where the seed changes. If I'm doing this on the same day, anything natural like this will not just disappear. But if I made this world in the last update, then I come to a new update, then the village might be gone. But here's the key, anything man-made, I can definitely change no matter the time. I hope that made sense. But yeah, anyways, lava is gone, purple still there. That is how you do it, guys. So to conclude this video, be careful, be safe, but if your world is giant, it's too big, whatever the case is, use this tool, it is amazing. And if I didn't already mention it, you might want to make a backup. But no, all jokes aside, thanks so much for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, do all the good stuff, and I'll talk to you guys next time. So until then, goodbye.